Hey guys, new pregnancy update coming at you with Rachel from the dark side. I dyed my hair yesterday. I'm really, really happy with it. It will fade a little bit. Obviously, when you first get it done, it's pretty dark with the fresh dye. I think after I shower a few times, it will kind of fade, and I have a lot of caramely highlights throughout, so I'm just really thrilled with how it turned out. I love it. So excited. So I wanted to update you on weeks 8, 9, and 10. I'm 11 and a half weeks now, so kind of like 8 through 10 weeks that I'm going to update in this video, and I'm going to start with probably my biggest pregnancy symptom this pregnancy, which is my nausea and vomiting issue. It really peaked in week 9. It was really, really bad. So basically right after I filmed the last pregnancy update, I was the worst I was the whole pregnancy, any pregnancy. And I ended up starting to prophylactically take Zofran at 3. I set my watch alarm for 3:18 in the morning for some reason. And I take Zofran at that time, and that has completely mitigated my morning sickness, completely. I have not thrown up since I did that. I do get pretty nauseous in the evenings, but I can usually kind of snack and get through it, get to bed. Sometimes I'll take a half of a Zofran right before bed, just so I can like get rid of that queasy feeling and go to sleep. And then I'll take one at 3:18, a half of one at 3:18, and I'm usually good to go. All of the things that I tried before I started taking Zofran, which honestly is just a half of a pill a day. I'm okay with it. All the things I tried, none of them worked. I tried waking up and eating a cracker immediately before I even got out of bed. I tried Unisom and B6. I'm actually still taking Unisom and B6 before bed. And I don't know if it's helping. I haven't stopped doing it, but I was still throwing up while I was doing that. So hard to say whether that's helping or not. I even did take like the prescription Diclegis for a little while, and then that prescription ran out and it just wasn't helping, so I stopped taking that. I tried ginger capsules, Dramamine, pregnancy safe ginger. That didn't help, I don't think, at all. And I think that's it. So all of those things I had tried. Zofran was a last resort for me, and it has been truly life-changing since I started taking that. So that is a really, really positive thing. I will say I did my own research on Zofran and then did some anecdotal research on Instagram, just asking of all of my friends on Instagram who had taken Zofran, what reason they took it, if it was just to like not feel queasy at all, or if it was because they were throwing up constantly and didn't want to be doing that. And so many people have taken it and everything was fine. I know that's anecdotal. The studies show that it's pretty safe. There are definitely a few things that are like correlated with Zofran, but I don't think that they've ever determined causation. So anyway, I'm comfortable with what I'm doing, and everybody should do their own research and just kind of make their own decision regarding Zofran. But for me, it's been life-saving and I can function now, and then that is like a great thing. And so I'm probably in a couple of weeks going to experiment going off of taking that prophylactically in the middle of the night. Once again, I'm showing way sooner, way, way sooner than any prior pregnancy. And that just comes with the territory of consecutive pregnancies and then also being pregnant with multiples again. So yeah, I don't know. I'm going to see my OB in like 2 weeks, not next week, but the week after. And I'm just curious to see like how the babies are measuring and how my uterus is measuring. I remember being so shocked with my first twin pregnancy when they would always measure me, and I would always measure about 8 weeks ahead of whatever week I was. And that's pretty typical of twins, is that when you're 10 weeks, you measure 18 weeks. And when you're 20 weeks, you measure 28 weeks. And when you're 37 weeks, you're measuring 45 weeks. So that's all pretty normal. But yeah, I'll have an appointment in 2 weeks and we'll see. Speaking of babies, they're great. I had an ultrasound this past week and they were measuring a little bit ahead of schedule, and heart rates were good, and they have arms and legs and fingers and toes. Nothing's webbed anymore. They're pretty much full babies. It's just really, really cool to see. I'll insert some footage here of their ultrasound, but it's just really cool to see a full baby that's recognizable as a baby after seeing, I mean, just like a blob really on ultrasound for so long. So that's really, really neat. And they're the size of a Lego person. I think they're about 3 inches tall. That's pretty cute. And I think a Lego person is a really good depiction of size because it's shaped like a person. One very, very positive thing this pregnancy is that I'm more emotionally stable than I feel like I was with Eloise. And comparing to my first twin pregnancy, I was pretty stable with that one. I don't know. I just didn't have as much going on in my life, to be completely honest. I didn't have the life stressors that I have now. We were just, I don't know. We were just a young married couple and really only had to worry about ourselves and my pregnancy, and that was it. And we both worked, and that was a good thing too. With this pregnancy, you know, obviously I'm parenting. We're building a house, we're managing some social media stuff, and I'm pregnant with twins. And I also have been through, I feel like once you've been postpartum, you're never the same. I'm sorry if you're like in your first pregnancy and this is terrifying you. It's not a bad thing, but I just don't feel like you're ever the same once you're postpartum. Obviously you have children now and that's different than you've ever experienced, but I don't know. And maybe it's because I've either been pregnant or breastfeeding almost constantly for the last 4 and a half years. But it's, I don't know. What am I trying to even say? I do feel like I'm more emotionally stable. And now going through this pregnancy, I'm taking Zoloft and Cymbalta. And that's been something I've been doing for the last 8 months or so. And it has really done a great job of just leveling my emotions, and I don't get as anxious as I used to get. I didn't even realize, and I've said this a few times, I did not realize how debilitating my anxiety was until I finally got to a place where I was regulated and normal. And I will never not talk about this again because I shied away from the topic when I was postpartum with the twins. That's the first time I really, like, really had bad postpartum depression. And I glossed over it in one particular video where I was postpartum. I didn't even really talk about it. And that was wrong because it feeds into the fact that, like, this is taboo and this is something people shouldn't talk about. That's just not true at all. There are so many people suffering with the same type of thing. And it's silly to not be talking about it because it, just like somebody with diabetes has uncontrolled blood sugar, somebody with anxiety and depression has some dysregulation of their, like the brain chemistry. So taking a medication to help stabilize that is not anything to be ashamed of. And it just gets a bad rap because when you have anxiety or depression, your mood, people are triggered by your mood, I guess. And that's on them. That's not on you. So anyway, that's a little bit of a tangent, but good news is I felt really stable this pregnancy, and I'm actually being monitored and regulated by both my OB and my psychiatrist. And my psychiatrist is under the firm belief that both of the medications I'm on are not only safe, but the benefits of them outweigh any minimal, not known even, risk. So that is what I'm going with. And yeah, I'm really happy that I'm so far, fingers crossed, I am like meeting with my psychiatrist sooner than I would. I normally do every 6 months, and I'm going to meet with her a little bit sooner next month just to kind of check in because she knew that I was hopefully going to be pregnant then. But we'll see how things keep going. I know things can change at any time, so I'm just really aware of that. And yeah, so that's really a good positive update. One thing that I find super interesting is that I'm not near as tired as I was with Eloise's pregnancy. I remember being pretty tired with the twins. Like when I was at work, I had just this small office in this really small town, and when I was pregnant with the first twins. And so at lunchtime, I had my own office within the office, and I would literally close the door, lay under my desk and sleep during lunch. So I was pretty tired with the twins. And then with Eloise, I remember being just so exhausted the first trimester. And I think part of that had to do with the fact that we had barely one-year-old twins. And so I was very hands-on still in the parenting stuff. But I don't feel like I'm as tired this time as I was my first two pregnancies, which is a good thing because I don't have a whole lot of time to be tired. I do have more trouble recovering if I don't get good sleep. So last night and the night before, Eloise was awake from like 4 to 4:30 or 5, just wanting somebody to hold her. And so Brad and I kind of took turns being with her in the middle of the night and trying to get her to go back to sleep until her normal morning time. So that was not fun. And because of that, I'm more tired today than I would be, I think, normally if I wasn't pregnant, but if I weren't pregnant. And I also am like making very frequent trips to the bathroom at night. It seems like I don't pee that much during the day, and it's not like I'm chugging a bunch of water at bedtime. So I don't really understand why all of a sudden at night, I just feel like I have to pee all the time, but that's what I'm doing. So I probably average 3 or 4 times a night that I'm getting up to go pee. And I am kind of related to that. I'm craving ice water, and I'm more thirsty this pregnancy than I was with Eloise. And it's very comparable to my first twin pregnancy. So I think it has something to do with the fact that, you know, you have two babies, so you have two sacs and two sources of amniotic fluid. And like my body not only processes my fluids, but my body processes their amniotic fluid and turns it over as well. So I'm turning over the fluid for two amniotic sacs and my own. And that's probably why there's a lot of urination happening, but that's all of this is so TMI. I'm sorry if you don't care. I guess if you don't care, you shouldn't click on a pregnancy update video, but it's a lot of peeing, a lot of vomiting. Oh, it's all just so glamorous. I had a really bad headache today. That's not been the normal. Like I had really bad headaches the first couple of weeks I was pregnant, weeks like 5 and 6. And those have pretty much gone away besides one here and there. And then I had one today, and I think it was just because we were running around all morning and I wasn't drinking enough water. So that's not the norm. But I never get headaches like normally when I'm not pregnant. So any headaches I can attribute to pregnancy usually, because that's not something I typically experience. Oh yes, okay, so I'm filming this on my phone, which is why I have to like keep pushing the button, but I think the vlog camera's in the car and I just couldn't be bothered to walk out there. One of them has an anterior placenta. I think it was baby A has an anterior placenta and baby B has a posterior placenta. So I'm glad they're not both anterior like they were with my first twins. Anterior placentas really cushion any feeling of kicks. So I'm really glad that at least one of them has a posterior placenta. There was a huge difference in feeling kicks from the outside when Brad could actually feel kicks. There was a difference between the twins and with Eloise, she had a posterior placenta, which just means that the placenta is in the back instead of on the surface of your belly. None of them are like placenta previa. It doesn't matter because I have to have a C-section this time. That's another thing. I've asked my OB already and she's, you know, I think if I had an OB that was kind of open to doing a vaginal delivery, I might be more open to it this time. And I think that's so weird because I was dead set against it with Eloise. But again, I was in a weird place emotionally and that was a very surprise pregnancy and all that. But anyway, I think I would maybe entertain the idea of doing a vaginal delivery this time, but I don't have that option. So it's a C-section again because I've had two prior C-sections. So that's kind of a bummer, but what are you gonna do? But yeah, there are one's anterior and one's posterior, and I'm curious to see when I can start feeling kicks. Leave a comment below with like the earliest you for sure knew you were feeling baby kicks. I think mine was around 18 weeks or something. So I'm almost, let's see, I say almost 12 weeks because I always round up. I turned 11 weeks on Thursday and today's Saturday, so I'm 11 weeks and 2 days. That's almost 12 weeks, right? But I think that's pretty much it for updates. I don't think I'll do like a bump update because I'm wearing baggy sweats and a baggy sweatshirt. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you haven't already and hit the thumbs up button to help this video. And we'll see you in our next vlog. Bye.